Welcome everyone. My name is Harshit Srivastav and today I'm going to discuss about Internet of the Things, that is IoT. Internet of Things can be simply defined as an environment or you can say the collection of various devices, objects that can be connected to a network. And especially the network can be the internet. There may be some other forms of the network like intranet and some other. But in general, we talk about the internet. So these devices are connected to the internet and by this they are being able to connect with each other. And when they are being able to connect with one another, then they can be able to share the resources. They can be able to optimize the task. They can be able to reduce the human to human and manual dependency of doing a task. So let's have a recall over the history of the Internet of the Things. The Internet of the Things is seventh in the series of Internet reports that was originally launched in the year 1997. In the year 1999, there was an Auto ID Center that had been founded in the Massachusetts Institute of the Technology, and further there were more advancement and by the year 2008, there was the first international conference on the Internet of the Things that was held in the Zurich. Okay, so now before going much detail on the Internet of the Things, we need to understand that what is the need of the Internet of the Things, why we are going to use and learn the Internet of the Thing. So knowing this thing, the need of the Internet thing, is a very important and plays a vital role. So Internet of the Things is used because we want to control everything remotely. Consider a situation that you are driving your car and suddenly you know that the season is very warm and you think that I need to on my air conditioner that is placed in my living room so that when I will reach to my home I will get a cool environment. How you can do this task? I think without Internet of the Things you cannot be able to do this task, but with the help of the Internet of the Thing you can be able to do this task at the finger of your tips. So there are more things. We want everything to control remotely. Another thing which is very important, that Internet of Things has not only reduced the manual task, the human's task, the routine task, but also it has saved our money and time. And Internet of the Things today is widely used to improve the decision making system. Either that decision making system would be of any business or to solve any engineering problem, the Internet of the Things and devices are being used. Also, we need to use the Internet of the Things so that we would be able to for immediate share the resources, immediate share the devices, receiving and analyzing the huge amount and bulk amount of the data. So now let's have a look at how the IoT works. The main thing and the first thing that comes into an act is the connectivity. First of all, there must be a need of connectivity to the various devices. And how we can achieve that connectivity? We achieve that connectivity with the use of a network, especially an internet. After the devices, the sensor devices, they have been connected, there comes a role of the sensors and the devices. And these sensors and devices, they are tracking the data from the environment. Like an soil moisture sensor, which is working to measure the moisture of the soil, would start working when it got connected over a network, and sensor will start working. After the sensor starts working, there comes a role of the data processing. When we get the data, then we need to process the data. And data processing and data analytics is a huge part of how we convert the raw data into some meaningful information. How we can be able to extract some meaningful information from that data, that is the time. And when we are able to extract the data some in form of some meaningful information, then we would be able to provide this as an to the user as a user interface. And by this, the user would be able to see all the things at the finger of its tips. That is, he can see on the mobile phone, on any electronic equipment for that he would be working. So that is the basic mechanism of Internet of the Things. So now we need to know about the current status of the Internet of the Thing, especially we are talking about the India. In India, majorly it is being used by three sectors. The first one we can say about government. Government, how the government is using the Internet of Things. Government of India has a plan to make the city smarter by having an initiative of smart city. So, in order to fulfill the smart city, smart cities must be need to connected with some wireless devices. They must be need to provide some wireless sensors. They must be need to they need of a smart roads. So for this, the government is trying to make a good plan and good strategy so that he can be implement and fulfill the dream of smart cities in our India. The next thing we can talk about the industries. In industries, there are various industries in which you can say that on the conveyor belt, there is a use of sensors and devices by which while the product is being packed on the packaging of the product, it is marked up with a special barcode or a special symbol by which the person who is scanning such a barcode can be able to read the details of that product. Moreover, the information about shipping and delivery of the product can be traced with the use of Internet of the Things. Now we talk about the startups. How startups use an Internet of the Things? You know about Ola cabs, and there are different you can say cab companies. When the Ola cab started, he thought that there must be a need of network so that we can be able to get the address of the person who is waiting for the cab, who has booked the cab, where the cab would go, so that we can trace each and every path that is traveled by that cab, and we have a more accurate and precise information about road networks, about traffic situation and lot of things. So startups also use the Internet of a Thing. Now we talk about the potential of the Internet of the Things. The potential of the Internet of the Things is very wide, and especially Internet of a Things becomes a powerful mechanism and powerful device when it is used with an internet. So Internet of Things will enable us to create a smart cities, as I have discussed about smart cities, that there would be smart road, there can be the use of the Wi-Fi facility and lot of things. Also, there are uses of the smart car. In a smart car would be able to see the path, so to trace the location of where the car would have to go, and the car would also be able to choose the optimal path for going towards the reaching to the destination. By this, it not only saves the fuel of the car but also saves the time of a driver by telling him about the traffic situations at the different road, you can say routes of the road. Also, we talk about the smart homes. The smart homes would consist of that. The smart home would consist of the smart, you can say, electric equipments, electric bulbs, different type of machinery, smart security system, by which they can be able to provide that which system is opened and where is the need of opening the system and all these things. And that would be able to save the energy. Suppose the owner of the house would be able to know that in which part of the room the electricity, electric bulbs are open and there is no need to open on that place. So he can switch off it by his finger of the tips, by his mobile phone. So it can be implemented, it has been implemented by the use of the IoT, Internet of the Things. Also, by the context of the public safety, Internet of the Things can be considered very significant, and it's playing a very important role, because by the public safety, you can say that different types of the people, they are roaming, and they can be able to check it by different type of devices, GPS system, especially by the good networks. Dial 100 is there, and lot of things are being modified with the use of Internet of the Things. If we talk about the energy conservation, so we know that if the unnecessary lights and bulbs can be remotely switched off and on, especially off, so a lot of electricity will also be saved. That will save an energy. And in terms of the agriculture, we talk about that there are various sensors that are capable of measuring the soil's moisture, that are being capable of providing the optimal solution, what to reap, where to reap, the absolute temperature of that place, the humidity of the crops, and lot of things are there. And these type of things will enhance the agricultural system and will provide an optimal solution for different problems in the agricultural system. Now, I would request my friend Mr. Anmol Srivastav to further proceed on the topic of IoT.
Yeah, so with the continuation of the speech and discussion over the Internet of Things, let me introduce the next topic, that is, what is the future of Internet of Things? Actually, the future of Internet of Things is very bright. There's a lot of scope, and in terms of employment opportunities, in terms of our growth and development in every sector. So let me tell first that Internet of Things is being generated on the large data, on the basis of a big data. So the amount of data and quantity of data that is generated with the help of our Internet of Things will increase, and with it increase the accountability and responsibility to every and each and every citizen and organization. It will make each and every city a smart city by implementing a wireless connectivity by enhancing and boosting the communication system, and by enhancing the communication in the various field. It has a further implementation and it has a wide scope in the medical and research. There's a lot of equipments like a medical kit, like heavy equipments and machines, surgeries machines, and these are the medical equipments in which there's a lot of implementation and use of IoT. With the help of a sensors that is being passed by these medical equipments, we can trace the where we have to where the patient needs actual surgery, what is the need of a place where we have to make a surgery, and which part there is a problem, in which organ there is any kind of problem. And there is a lot of scope in a research work also. Development of more precise solution of business is also one of the important and practical implementation, and there is a lot of scope that is being involved in the engineering and business problems. So let me introduce the next slide, that is application of IoT. Yeah, the first application of IoT that is being involved in a medicine. Yeah, actually with the help of our internet of the thing, we can able to optimize, we can able to enhance the performance of every medical equipments and devices. We can connect the each and every hospitals with the help of our IoT, and we can upload these connections on our server, that is a big data, which facilitate the patients and doctor to connect with their patients directly without being able to wasting their time and searching the hospitals and patients. Patient can directly contact with the doctors. Secondly, the healthcare. Healthcare has a very important use of IoT. As I told you that all the hospitals and clinic can be connected with the IoT server. And what happened after connecting this? We can able to trace out the location in which hospitals we have to go. We can able to get the information of each and every hospitals, what are the hospital condition, what are the doctors that are available in these hospitals, and what are the rates of different hospitals, and etc. Another is the smart city. As you all know that smart city contains the advanced wireless connectivity that can make each and every person accountable. That means the implementation of advanced and good qualities of cameras, traffic signals, and advanced equipments that makes our city small, and especially the inner transportation and communication and etc. Other application of IoT, that is the business. Yeah, actually there is a wide scope in a business for optimizing the analyzing the consumer behavior, for analyzing the sales report, and for analyzing the stock inventory, and also to analyze and to help in the recruitment of a staff. We can also able to use the IoT in every department, that is a manufacturing, planning, organizing, staffing, and every department to facilitate the business and to grow the business. Next is automotive. Automotive has a very wide application of IoT. You know that today each and every vehicles are connected to a server through a GPS. With the help of a GPS, if you on the GPS, then you can able to trace out the location of a particular vehicle. You can also able to know that what is the exact location, or what is the route of a particular path where I want to travel. So in this way, all the sectors in our country can be able to connected with the applications of IoT. So our next slide, that is the challenges of IoT. My friend, there's also a lot of challenges that is being involved in IoT, like security challenge, because you know that each and every equipment is being connected to a common network platform, that is IoT. So these chances of a hacking in the system, because these are system that works, that emit the signals, and it can be hacked by any hacker and can be remotely accessed and controlled by a third party. Lot of data involved in this IoT system, because in IoT system works only on the data that is being held by the signals. So have a proper accountability and storage facility of these data is also very important and important issue that is involved in the IoT. Business models also involve that it also involves a cost in implementing the IoT servers, like implementing the server IoT, you know that signals and equipments and connecting with each involves a lot of complexity. Even you can know that even many people who are illiterate, if they are not able to use the IoT, so they are not take an advantage of IoT. They cannot connect their equipments to the IoT, and that is a problem that is being involved, especially in the developing countries like India. As I told you, that awareness is also important, that in our country there is not so much awareness regarding the IoT. Therefore, most of the companies are not involved in the use of IoT. So that is the important thing. In order to develop our business, in order to grow our country, we should able to recognize the importance of IoT in every field in order to grow and in order to become a developed nation. So our next slide, that is the criticism and controversies that are being involved in IoT or Internet of Things. Security is the most important problem. Yeah, it is rightly written that a security breach is a major controversy that is involved in IoT. Although many of the scientists and research teams are working to reduce the problem of our security, and we will surely get rid of that. Secondly, the ability of IoT can easily track an object. Yeah, it is also right that all the devices that is being connected with the IoT, and so there is a problem that is involved in the privacy of a network. Means if you are using a smartphone or even if you are using your air conditioner, so there is not a privacy that is being involved there, because it can be controlled by third party also because of a security problem. So our next slide, that is the IoT as a network of a networks. Yeah. So in this diagram, in this circular diagram, you can see that there are major important sectors, that is transport, energy, education, businesses, and even a home. Means these are the sectors, these are the places where the human beings involved, where the human works. So with that, these are the things that can be easily connected with the IoT, and we can able to utilize the maximum benefit by having a connection. The networks connected with added security, analytics, and management capabilities, and in this way our systems, our whole networks in which we are operating, whether it is home, whether it is office, any plant, any business, it will become more powerful and accountable. And in this way, we have a proper accountability of each and everything what is being involved in this, in our life and in our business also. So On our last slide, that is conclusion of IoT involves. So, as I told you that there's a lot of things today, IoT has become a part of our life. We are also a part of our IoT. We are also connected with each other with the help of the relationship. We have different relations with our parents, our teachers, our children. In a similar way, with the help of IoT, these are the devices which we connected with the same way in the relationship of our signals. And this will improve a lot. So it can be summed up that IoT is working in a development of emerging technology. Yeah, it is rightly that there is a lot of technology that is being involved behind IoT, that is the big data, cloud, artificial intelligence, AI, and gateways. So these are the things that will be involved for the implementation of IoT. And lastly, we can conclude that IoT is not a new concept, but there's a lot more thing to analyze, there's not a lot more things to explore in this IoT. And I think that after some time, after a few years, we were able to get very aware regarding implementation and use of IoT, and we will able to enjoy the benefits and facilities that is being involved in IoT in a digital village, in a digital era. Thank you.